What is up, everyone? I am Banwell, and today I'm bringing you guys the 9.2 Windwalker Monk PvP guide. This guide is going to be for Necrolord Windwalkers, and we're going to be going over everything from your talents, your damage rotation, how to survive, and your best comps. Let's dive right into it and not waste any time. In the 15 tier, none of these talents are that important. I like to use Chi Wave because you can kill Sky Fury totems. It actually does use as a 1k on-use heal as well if you're ever that low on health. But again, you can play Windwalker without any of these talents. Tiger's Lust, you need every single game. It has incredible utility for both you and your teammates. Fist of the White Tiger is a requirement to play Necrolord because you need to be able to build G without proccing your Kiefers. Ring of Peace is one of the most versatile and impactful abilities in all of WoW, so you're going to play that in every arena. Diffuse Magic can't really be replaced this season with how popular priests are. Plus, with the Resonator trinkets, you pretty much always need to have Diffuse Magic. Dance of Chi Gi is what Windwalkers are known for in Shadowlands. That's our big spin proc, our massive one-shot that you've probably seen. And lastly, Whirling Dragon Punch, which is a talent that you will swap out for Serenity when you fight some double caster teams like Frostmage Warlock or Frostmage Druid that has a lot of roots and it makes your images really hard. But for 90% of the games, you're going to play Whirling Dragon Punch. The legendary for Necro Windwalker that you're going to play is the Kiefer Skyreach. This gives you 50% crit chance on a 1-minute cooldown. You activate it by using Tiger Palm on that target. When you combine this with your Bone Dust Brew, Leg Sweep, and Images, which are all 1-minute cooldowns, that you will have some absolutely huge burst. The other benefit of Kiefers is the added mobility, 10-yard range on your Tiger Palm, lets you teleport to targets, teleport to them to land kicks. It can also let you juke CC, like another Windwalker's Leg Sweep or a Hunter's Trap, if you Tiger Palm at the right time. In terms of the rest of the gear for this season, I'm stacking as much mastery as I can, especially this Necrolord with this Fleshcraft mastery buff. You get the extra 120 mastery, so you see I'm about 38% mastery, 24% crit, and I've dropped a little bit of verse to do that by not wearing versatility on this crafted ring. You don't have to gear like that. I like it. This is the max damage build. I'm sacrificing a little bit of verse, which makes me a little less tanky, but not terribly since stats DR, and increases my damage. I'm hitting 33 to 35k Rising Sun Kick crits with my images out, and it feels really, really good. Next, let's get into our basic damage rotation. All you're going to do is keep Rising Sun Kick, Fist of Fury, and Whirling Dragon Punch on cooldown. You'll save your Spinning Crane Kick procs for your one-shot. If you have no one-shot available, you'll use them as they proc as well. And when nothing else is possible, you're going to Chi Wave and Blackout Kick to reduce the cooldowns of your other spells. Keep your Rising Sun Kick on cooldown, use your spins when they proc, keep Fist of Fury and Whirling Dragon Punch on cooldown. Remember that Whirling Dragon Punch, Fist of Fury, and Rising Sun Kick are all reduced, their cooldown is reduced, by your haste. So keeping your PvP talent Alpha Tiger up as often as you can without wasting Kiefer's procs is huge to get out your maximum damage. The one-shot for Windwalker is very simple. You apply your Bone Dust Brew, proc your Kiefers, use your images, Rising Sun Kick, Fist of Fury, and Whirling Dragon Punch. If you have a Spinning Crane Kick proc, you can Spinning Crane Kick and Rising Sun Kick during the channel for your absolute biggest one-shot. It looks something like this. You'll build up your Chi, apply your Bone Dust, Leg Sweep, Images, Kiefers, RSK, Fist of Fury, into a Whirling Dragon Punch. That's 20,000 DPS on this target dummy, almost entirely single target. With a Spinning Crane Kick proc, it'll look slightly different. Your Spinning Crane Kick one-shot looks slightly different. You're going to apply your Bone Dust Brew, use your on-use, Kiefers, Leg Sweep, and then Spinning Crane Kick and Rising Sun Kick during the spin. If they somehow live that, you'll follow it up with your standard Fist of Fury into Whirling Dragon Punch. The thing to remember about spin is that the more stacks you have, the more damage it does thanks to our conduit and the class ability itself. To get stacks, you attack a new target. It gives them a buff for 20 seconds that increase the damage of Spinning Crane Kick. 2 stacks, 3 stacks, 4 stacks, and now my 5 stacks. This Spinning Crane Kick is doing almost 400% more damage than your normal Spinning Crane Kick does. Defensively, Windwalker's lacking a lot. Touch of Karma is one of the worst defensive cooldowns in the game. You can die right through it every time. Fortifying Brew is the exact same way. The best part about Fortifying Brew is the conduit, Fortifying Ingredients, which gives you a 33% shield, shield for 33% of your total health. However, you can die through both very easily. Diffuse Magic is a very high value defensive cooldown, but it is only gets good value into casters like mages, warlocks, elemental shamans. And since they have so much damage and are often paired with a melee that does physical damage, it's often not enough to save you. That leaves mobility as our best defensive cooldown. Using your port properly, your rolls, flying serpent kick, and tiger's lust is absolutely essential to surviving games, as well as using your ring of peace and improved disable to root enemies off of snares. One last thing, guys. Reverse harm you use on cooldown. That is your best chi generating ability and your best healing ability. So you want to make sure you're using that off of cooldown and making sure that it is always on CD. And with that, we're all done. If you have any questions, make sure you drop them in the comments. If you're interested in private one-on-one coaching lessons, make sure you add me on Discord. There's a link in the description. If you want to see more YouTube videos, make sure you subscribe, like, and comment. Let me know what you guys want to see. I'll be coming out with more class guides. I've been playing a lot of classes for those who watch my stream. And if you haven't watched my stream, make sure you check it out. Twitch.tv/BanwellX. And until next time, peace.